Hello everyone, myself Dr. Narendra Parihar, Assistant Professor. On the behalf of Progressive Education Society, Modern College of Pharmacy, I welcome you all again back. Today we will see the drug metabolism of the drug. So this is the pharmacokinetics which we are still continuing. Drug metabolism is also known as a biotransformation of a drug, that is a chemical alteration of the drug in a living organism is called a biotransformation. See, metabolism of the drug usually converts lipid soluble and unionized compounds into water solubles and ionized compounds. As we all study in the first year, that is the liver is the main site for the drug metabolism, or you can say the liver is the main organ which metabolizes or the degradation of the drugs where the happens. So before that, we will see what is prodrug. Prodrug is an inactive form of drug which is converted to an active form after metabolism. So when you swallow a drug, it gets disintegrated into dissolution, then it bonds to the protein. If the protein gets activated attaches to the drug, for example, the drug attaches to the protein, still the drug is not in the active form. It will get into the metabolism, then the inactive form of drug will be converted into the active form. So what is the use of prodrug? To improve the bioavailability. For example, Parkinsonism is due to deficiency of dopamine. So dopamine itself cannot be used since it does not crosses the blood-brain barrier, as we have seen. So it is given in the form of prodrug levodopa. So levodopa crosses the blood-brain barrier and it then converted into the dopamine. So as you can see, levodopa enters in the blood-brain barrier, then levodopa is converted into the with the help of the enzyme dopa decarboxylase into dopamine. So why prodrug? To prolong the duration of action, to improve the taste, to provide the site-specific drug delivery. Okay. Now, in the drug metabolism, it includes two pathways. Okay. So first is the phase one reaction, or it can also known as a non-synthetic reaction. And second is a phase two. It is a synthetic reaction. So we will see phase one reaction. Phase one reaction, it is again divided into five types of reactions. That is phase one. Oxidation means there is a addition of oxygen, or you can say removal of hydrogen. Drugs which goes under the oxidations are phenytoin, phenobarbital, pentobarbital, etc. Second, reduction means removal of oxygen or and addition of, you can say, hydrogen. So here the drugs which undergoes the reduction type of reaction is chloramphenicol and methadone. Third, hydrolysis, breakdown of compound by addition of water. So it is a common among the esters and amides. So esters, the drugs which undergoes hydrolysis are procaine, succinylcholine, and amides examples are lignocaine and procainamide. Next we will see fourth, that is a cyclization. The cyclization, there is a conversion of a straight chain compound into a ring structure. The example of drugs which undergo the cyclization reactions is progranil. And last is a decyclization, that is a breakup of the ring structure of the drug. So here the drugs which undergoes like phenobarbital and phenytoin. Remember, these are the five types of phase one reactions which occurs in the metabolism phase. Now we'll see phase two reaction. Phase two reaction consists of a conjugation reaction. If the phase one metabolite is polar, it is excreted in the urine or bile. However, many metabolites are lipophilic and undergoes subsequent conjugation with endogenous substrates such as glucuronic acid, sulfuric acid, etc. So these conjugates are polar, usually water soluble and inactive. So now we will see different types of conjugation reaction and their enzymes which are included and drugs which are undergoes phase 2 reaction for a conjugation specific reaction. First is a glucuronidation enzyme included. The examples are aspirin and morphine. Second, acetylation enzyme included, that is N-acetyl transferase drugs which undergoes like isoniazid and dapsone. So these are different phases of reactions which consists of different types of conjugation reactions, and these are very important for the drug metabolism. Now you'll see factors affecting drug metabolism are as follows. First is the age. Neonates and elderly metabolize some drugs to the lesser extent than adults. For example, neonate conjugate chloramphenicol more slowly, hence develop toxicity. For example, gray baby syndrome. Second factor is the diet. Poor nutrition can decrease the enzyme function. Then third, disease. Chronic diseases of liver may affect the hepatic metabolism of some drug. Example, increased duration of action of diazepam. In patients with cirrhosis due to its impaired metabolism. Fourth, genetic factors. It is as pharmacogenetic. The study of genetically determined variation in drug response is called pharmacogenetic. It is a slow and fast acetylators of isoniazid, succinylcholine apnea, glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency, and hemolytic anemia. Fifth parameter, like simultaneously administration of drugs, this can result in increase or decrease metabolism of drug. Means concurrent two drugs are swallowed or taken by the patient, it can also result in increase or decrease metabolism of the drug. Now we will see the enzyme induction. Enzyme induction, that is a repeated administration of a certain drug, increases the synthesis of microsomal enzyme. This is known as an enzyme induction. So drug is referred to an enzyme inducer, example rifampicin and phenytoin. As you can see the mechanism of enzyme induction. The clinical importance of microsomal enzyme induction. Enzyme inductions may accelerate the metabolism of drug, thus reducing the duration and intensity of drug action, leading to the therapeutic failure. Auto induction may lead to the drug toxicity. Enzyme induction can also lead to drug toxicity. Prolonged phenytoin therapy may produce osteomalacia due to enhanced metabolism of vitamin D3. Enzyme inducers, for example barbiturates, can precipitate porphyria due to overproduction of prophobulin. Enzyme induction can also be beneficial, for example phenobarbitone in neonatal jaundice. Phenobarbitone induces glucuronidation transferase enzyme, hence bilirubin is conjugated and jaundice is resolved. Now second, we will see the enzyme inhibition. There are certain drugs, for example chloramphenicol, ciprofloxacin, erythromycin, etc., inhibit the activity of drug metabolizing enzyme. So these are known as enzyme inhibitors. Inhibition of metabolism of one drug by another can occur when both are metabolized by the same enzyme. So enzyme inhibition is rapid process as compared to the enzyme induction. So remember, in the drug distribution, what is prodrug and different pathways of the drug metabolism, that is phase 1 reactions and phase 2 reactions, the note can be asked, and factors which are affecting the drug metabolism, and the enzyme induction and enzyme inhibition. So here we have done with the drug distribution. Now in next we will see the drug excretion. So what is drug excretion? So it is a removal of the drug and its metabolites from the body is known as drug excretion. There are different routes of excretion. Like major route is a renal and biliary excretion, which we have already studied in the first year. The minor routes are pulmonary, salivary, mammary excretion via milk, skin, and dermal excretion via sweat. Okay. So now first, the organ involved in the excretion is important is the kidney. So rate of renal excretion is equal to rate of filtration plus rate of secretion minus rate of reabsorption. A glomerular filtration. Drugs with smaller molecule size are more readily filtered. The extent of filtration is directly proportional to the glomerular filtration rate. and to the fraction of the unbound drug in plasma. Passive tubular reabsorption. The main factor affecting the passive reabsorption is the pH of the renal tubular fluid and the degree of ionization. Strongly acidic and strongly basic drug remains in ionized form at any pH of urine, hence are excreted in urine. Third, active tubular secretion. It is a carrier mediated active transport which requires energy. Active secretion is unaffected by changes in the pH of urine and protein binding. Most of the acidic drugs and basic drugs are secreted by the renal tubules. Second pathway of the drug excretion is through the lungs. Alcohol and volatile general anesthetics such as ether, halothane, isoflurane are excreted via lungs. Feces, drugs that are not completely absorbed from the GI tract are excreted in the feces. For example, purgative like senna, cascara, etc. Fourth, bile. Some drugs are excreted via bile, but after reaching the intestine, they are reabsorbed. Like we have seen enterohepatic circulation. See, from liver, the drugs get into the bile and the cycle is repeated. Such recycling of drug, or you can say excretion of drug, is also known as an enterohepatic circulation. And it increases the bioavailability as well as the duration of action of the drug. Skin. Metals like arsenic and mercury are excreted through skin. Saliva. Certain drugs like potassium iodide, phenytoin are excreted in saliva. Salivary estimation of lithium may be used for non-invasive monitoring of lithium therapy. And secretion through the milk. Drugs taken by lactating women may appear in the milk. It has acidic pH, hence basic drugs like tetracycline, chloramphenicol, etc. remain in an ionized form and are excreted through milk. They may affect the suckling infant. Factors affecting renal excretion of drug, that is renal blood flow. Increased perfusion leads to the increased excretion, important for drugs excreted by glomerular filtration. Second factor is the drug molecular weight. Larger the molecular weight, the drugs are difficult to excrete than smaller molecular weight, especially by glomerular filtration. Third is the drug lipid solubility. Increased the lipid solubility increases the volume of distribution of drug and decreases renal excretion. So here we have ended with the pharmacokinetic parameters, that is absorption, distribution, metabolism and drug excretion. Thank you for watching the video.